हेलो स्टूडेंट,
माई सेल्फ जिगर जे पटेल. टुडे आई एम टेकिंग ए सेशन ऑन रिवोक कमांड विच इज अ सब पार्ट ऑफ डीसीएल कमांड इन एडवांस एसक्यूएल. ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ करंट सेशन आर यूज ऑफ रिवोक कमांड एंड एग्जाम्पल ऑफ रिवोक कमांड. रिवोक कमांड इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ डीसीएल कमांड. DCL means Data Control Language command. This command is used to take our permission away from the user to a table. Revoke command का use अगर कोई user को हमने permission grant की है तो उससे वापिस लेने के लिए हम कर सकते हैं. Now with the help of revoke command, which permission will be take away from the user? So those permissions which are granted with the help of grant command, that permission only take away from the user. So revoking privileges means to deny permission to user given previously. Here given previously means those privileges which are granted with the help of grant command. We can revoke privilege only if you have been granted that privilege. हम वही परमिशन और वही प्रिविलेज वापस ले सकते हैं जो परमिशन हमने कोई यूजर को ग्रांट की है. और इफ वी आर एन एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर, सो हियर द सिंटैक्स ऑफ रिवोक कमांड, रिवोक देन ऑब्जेक्ट प्रिविलेज ऑन ऑब्जेक्ट नेम. सो हियर ऑब्जेक्ट नेम इज अ टेबल नेम फ्रॉम यूजर नेम. सो हियर those privileges which we want to take away from the user, that we have to write down at here object privilege. Then we have to write down a table name at here, and we have to write down the username at here. Now an example of revoke command: revoke select comma insert on customer from user 2. Here select and insert both are the permissions which we are take back from the user. Customer, that is my table name, while user 2, that is a user. So here a owner of table customer take a select and insert privileges from the user 2. So by this way we can deny the permissions to any user. So whenever we are executing this statement, it display an output like this: revoke succeeded. So by this way we can use a revoke command. Now let's see a practical demonstration on a revoke command. So here I'm logging with a user system. So your system is the owner of a table student. So here I'm writing my query: select star from student. So this is the total 10 records. Now I'm logging with another user, that is user 1. Now I'm writing select star from system dot student. So here we can see that here a user 1 have a privileges to select a record from a table student which is owned by a system user. It means a user 1 have a privileges to access a record of student table which is owned by a system user. Now we want to take back those permissions from user 1. So how we can do it? So that will be done from the user owner account or table owner account. So here system is a owner of a table student. So here I have to write down revoke. So which privilege I want to take back? A select privilege on table name, so that is its student, from user 1. So as soon as I'm writing this statement, it display a message revoke succeeded. It means a select permission is denied by a owner of student table for a user one. Now we are moving back to user one's account, and when we are writing the same query, select star from system dot student. So we can see that message insufficient privileges. It means a user one does not have a privilege select on a table student. So by this way, we can take a privileges from the user. Now, if you want to take all the permissions from any user, in that case, we have to write down revoke space all on table name. So that is student from username. So that is user one. So again, we can see that revoke succeeded. So here all means it will take all the permission back which are given with the help of grant command. Now let's see, execute the same statement again. Select star from system dot student. So in that case, we will get a different message, that is table or view does not exist. So what is the logic behind these two messages? First displaying insufficient privilege, while second display table or view does not exist. So the meaning of first error message, that is here we are trying to select a record from a student table, but it display a message insufficient privilege. It means a user one does not have a privilege to select a record from student table, but it contains or it have some another privileges like insert, update or delete on a student table. Okay, so whenever you are getting this type of message, it means that user have some different privilege on a table. But when you are getting this message, table or view does not exist. So meaning of that, a particular user does not contain any privilege or any permission to access that table. Okay, so it means there is no any privilege assigned to that user for that particular table. So by this way, we can use a revoke command in a multi-user environment. So thank you, everyone.